Hi dear students, welcome back to online classes. I am your Virupaksha BP. In last class we were discussing about molecular formula and empirical formula and the difference between molecular formula and empirical formula, and we were discussing about how to find out molecular formula and empirical formula. Today we are going to discuss about stoichiometry and stoichiometric calculations. It is very important for 2 marks. Stoichiometric calculations are very important for 2 marks. Okay, what is the stoichiometry? Stoichiometry, it is a Greek word. Stoichiometry means to measure of an element. What is stoichiometry? Stoichiometry is a branch of chemistry. It deals with the relative quantities of reactants and products in a balanced chemical reaction. Stoichiometry is a branch of chemistry. It deals with the relative quantities of reactants and products in a balanced chemical reaction. Balanced chemical reaction or chemical equation is called stoichiometry, right? Stoichiometry means the study of relative quantities of reactants and products in a chemical, a balanced chemical equation. The quantities, the quantities are like moles, mass and volume. The study of relative moles of reactants and products in a balanced chemical equation is called stoichiometry. What is balanced chemical equation? In balanced chemical equation, the number of atoms should be equal at both reactant and product side. The number of atoms should be equal at both reactant and product side. Then we call it as a balanced chemical equation. If number of atoms are equal at both reactant and product side, then we call it as a balanced chemical equation. Okay, now let us take one example. Combustion of methane. What is the meaning of combustion of methane? Means burning of methane in presence of excess air. Don't forget, combustion means burning in presence of excess air. The combustion of methane, that means burning of methane in excess air. Now let us write chemical equation. Methane. What is the chemical formula of methane? CH4. The chemical formula is CH4. When methane is burned in excess of oxygen, in presence of excess of oxygen, it gives carbon dioxide and water. It gives carbon dioxide and water. These two are reactants. When methane react with oxygen, then it gives two products. One is carbon dioxide, the another one is water. It is in gaseous state. This indicates it is in gaseous state. It is also in gaseous state. It is also in gaseous state. It is also in gaseous state. Here water is in vapor state, means in gaseous state. When methane burn in presence of excess air, it gives carbon dioxide and water. Okay, now check whether the reaction is balanced or not. How to check? What is balanced equation? First, the number of atoms should be equal at both reactant and product side. Now let us check, how many carbon atoms are there? One. In reactant side, there is one carbon. In product side, how many carbons are there? One. Now the carbon is balanced. Next, hydrogen. In reactant side, how many hydrogens are there? There are four hydrogens. In product side, how many hydrogens are there? There are two hydrogens. Now the hydrogen is not balanced. Okay, now oxygen. In reactant side, how many oxygens are there? Two. In product side, 2 + 1 = 3. That means this equation is not balanced. So when the reaction is not balanced, then you have to balance the reaction. To balance the reaction, you should follow on sequences. First you have to balance carbon. After balancing carbon, next you have to balance the hydrogen, and finally you have to balance the oxygen. You follow this order. First you have to balance the carbon, next hydrogen, next oxygen. Now first we balance carbon. Here one carbon, here one carbon. Carbon is balanced. Next hydrogens. Here there are four hydrogens, here there are two hydrogens. Now to balance hydrogen, here you have to put 2. Now 2 to 4, here 4. Hydrogen is balanced. The number of hydrogen atoms are equal at both reactant side and product side. Next, oxygen. The here in reactant side, there are two oxygens. In product side, 2, 4. There are four oxygens are present in product side. So to balance oxygen, you just put 2. Now the equation is balanced. This is a balanced equation. Now let us write stoichiometric coefficients. What is the coefficient of methane? What is the coefficient of methane? 1. What is the coefficient of oxygen? 2. What is the coefficient of carbon dioxide? 1. What is the coefficient of water? 2. These are called stoichiometric coefficients. Stoichiometric coefficients. The stoichiometric coefficients are equal to number of moles. Numerically, they are equal to number of moles. Here the stoichiometric coefficient is 1. That means there is 1 mole of methane. Okay, here the stoichiometric coefficient is 2. That means 2 mole of oxygen. Okay, here the stoichiometric coefficient is 1. That means 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Here there is 2. That means 2 mole of water. Okay. Then what is stoichiometry? The study of the relative moles of reactants and products. Now let us see. 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 mole of oxygen and gives 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 mole of oxygen and gives 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. Okay. For 1 mole of methane, how many moles of oxygen is required to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide? How many moles of oxygen is required? 2 moles. For 1 mole of methane, 2 moles of oxygen is required to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Okay, next. 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 22.4 liter. 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 22.4 liters. 2 moles is equal to how many liters? 44.8 liter. Just 2 into 22.4 liter. Next, 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 22.4 liters. 2 mole is equal to how many liters? 44.8 liter. That means 22.4 liter methane reacts with 44.8 liter of oxygen to produce 22.4 liter carbon dioxide and 44.8 liter water. For 22.4 liter methane, 44.8 liter of oxygen is required to produce 22.4 liter carbon dioxide, 44.8 liter water. Now let us write in terms of mass. 1 mole is equal to how many grams? 1 mole is equal to how many grams? 1 mole is equal to molar mass. What is the molar mass of methane? What is the molar mass of methane? 16 gram. How do you calculate molar mass? By adding atomic masses of all the elements in the molecule, we can calculate molar mass. What is the molar mass of oxygen? Here there are 2 moles. So 2 into molar mass of oxygen, we will get 64 grams. Next, 1 mole of carbon dioxide is equal to how many grams? 44 grams. Why? Because 1 mole of carbon dioxide is equal to molar mass. What is the molar mass of carbon dioxide? 44 grams. Next, 2 moles of water. 2 moles of water means 36 grams. See here. Now, the relative masses of reactants and products in a balanced equation. The study of relative masses of reactants and products is also called as stoichiometry. Now, let us see. 16 gram of methane reacts with 64 gram of oxygen to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide and 36 gram of water. Now tell me, for 16 gram of methane, how many grams of oxygen is required to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide and 36 gram of water? How many grams is required? 64 gram is required. Okay, this is stoichiometry. What is stoichiometry? It is the study of relative quantities of reactants and products in a balanced chemical equation. What is balanced chemical equation? Number of atoms should be equal at reactant and product side. Okay. Now example, combustion of methane. This is the stoichiometry. The next, limiting reagent. In stoichiometry only, we are discussing limiting reagent. Limiting reagent. What is limiting reagent? The reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely, that reactant is called limiting reagent. The reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely, that is called limiting reagent. See, what is limiting reagent? It is very important for 1 mark. They will ask definition, what is the limiting reagent? the reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely is called limiting reagent. It is very important for one mark. Definition is very important. Okay, now limiting reagent, this reagent, limiting reagent decide amount of product formed. Limiting reagent decides amount of product formed. Okay, this is very important point. Limiting reagent, it decides the amount of product during the chemical reactions. Why? Because in the chemical reactions we can see more than one reactant. In more than one reactant will be limiting reagent, another reactant will be excess reagent. What is the limiting reagent? The reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely, that is called limiting reagent. Then limiting reagent, it decide amount of product formed. The amount of product, it depends on limiting reagent. It is not depends on excess reagent. Then what is excess reagent? Now let us discuss excess reagent. Excess reagent means the reactant which is present in larger amount. The reactant which is present in larger amount and does not react completely or reacts incompletely is called excess reagent. The reactant which is present in large amount and reacts incompletely, that is called excess reagent. Now let us see one example. For example, A reactant reacts with B reactant and gives C product. This is one chemical reaction. A reactant reacts with B reactant and gives C product. Now let us see, what is the stoichiometric coefficient of A? 1. What is the coefficient of B? 2. Here 1, right? Its stoichiometric is 1, its stoichiometric coefficient is 2, its coefficient is 1. Now in the question they have mentioned the number of moles, number of A moles and number of B moles. They have given 5 moles. A 5 moles, B is 20 moles. Now find out which is limiting reagent and which is excess reagent between these two reactants. In this chemical reaction there are two reactants. One is A reactant, the another one is B reactant. Now you have to find out which is limiting reagent and which is excess reagent. First, if you know definition, then you can easily find out which is limiting and which is excess. What is limiting reagent? The reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely. Excess reagent means the reactant which is present in larger amount and reacts incompletely. Now let us check, what is the ratio according to this equation? For 1 mole of A, how many moles of B is required? For 1 mole of A, 2 moles of B is required to produce 1 mole of carbon, 1 mole of C, 1 mole of C. Then for 5 moles of A, how many moles of B is required? How many moles of B is required? For 1 mole of A, 2 moles of B is required. For 5 moles of A, how many moles of B is required? Just see here, double, 1, 2, double, right? Here 5 moles, 5 into double means what? 10 moles. 10 moles is required. 10 moles of B is required. But how many moles of B is given? 20 moles. That means the B reactant is in excess. The number of moles is required 10. But the given number of moles is 20. That's why B is excess reagent. It is excess reagent. Then it is a limiting reagent. Limiting reagent. Why? Because it, the reactant which is present in smaller amount and reacts completely. Here 5 moles of A completely reacts with 10 moles of B. That's why it is limiting reagent. Why it is excess reagent? Why? Because for 5 moles of A, just only 10 moles of B is required. But there are 20 moles of B is given. That's why it is excess reagent. It is in larger amount and it is incompletely react. Why? Because there is 10 moles extra is there. This is limiting reagent and excess reagent. Now let us see stoichiometric calculations. The first one, calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. He is asking, calculate amount of water produced after combustion of 16 gram of methane. Now first you have to write equation. Combustion of methane, that means what? The burning of methane in presence of oxygen, excess oxygen. Now let us write equation. Methane, what is the chemical formula of methane? CH4. Methane is in gaseous state. Combustion, that means burning in presence of oxygen, that's why O2. It is also in gaseous state. When methane or any hydrocarbon, if it is burned in presence of excess oxygen, the products are same, carbon dioxide and water. The products are same, carbon dioxide and water. You remember, when hydrocarbons are burned in presence of excess air, the products are carbon dioxide and water. Now let us check whether it is balanced or not. Here there are one carbon, here there is one carbon. Carbon is balanced. Here how many hydrogens are there? 4. Here how many hydrogens are there? 2. Now it is balanced. It is not balanced. To balance hydrogen, you just put here 2. Okay. Next, oxygen. How many oxygen atoms are there? Here 2. Here 2 plus 2 oxygen, 4. To balance oxygen, just you put 2. Now the equation is balanced. Next, you write stoichiometric coefficients. What is the stoichiometric coefficient of methane? 1. That means 1 mole. Right? 1 mole of methane. What is the coefficient of oxygen? 2. That means what? 2 mole oxygen. What is the coefficient of carbon dioxide? 1. That means 1 mole. What is the coefficient of water? 2. That means 2 mole. Correct? Okay. Now let us check question. Calculate amount of water. Amount means mass. Mass of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. Here we need in grams. So we have to convert moles into gram. Let us check. 1 mole of methane is equal to how many grams? 1 mole of methane is equal to molar mass of methane. What is the molar mass of methane? 16 gram. Okay. Next, what is the molar mass of oxygen? 32. 2 moles. What is the 2 moles of oxygen? 2 moles of oxygen is equal to how many grams? 64 grams. Okay. Next, what is the 1 mole of carbon dioxide is equal to how many grams? 44 grams. 2 moles of water is equal to how many grams? 36 grams. don't confuse. Just these values are came by adding atomic masses of all the atoms present in the molecule. Now I will show you how these values are obtained. For example, methane CH4, right? What is the, how many carbon atoms are there? 1. What is the atomic mass of carbon? 12. Plus how many hydrogens are there? 4. What is the atomic mass of hydrogen? 1. 16. That is 16 gram molar mass. 1 mole methane is equal to molar mass. Similarly, there are 2 moles of oxygen are there. Now oxygen, 1 mole oxygen mass is 32 gram. Why? Because there are 2 oxygen. 2 into atomic mass of oxygen, 2 into 16, 32. There are 2 moles are there. That's why you multiply with 2. Then you will get 64 gram. Similarly, it is also 1 mole of carbon dioxide is equal to 44 grams. 2 moles of water is equal to 36 gram. Now let us see what he is asking. He is asking to calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. When 16 gram of methane is burned in presence of excess air, then how many grams of water is produced? Now tell me, 16 gram of methane, when it burn in presence of excess oxygen, how many grams of water is produced? 36. The answer is 36. 36 gram of water is produced. When 16 gram of methane is burned in presence of excess oxygen. Okay, in this way we have to calculate the amount of water formed. Next, go for second numerical. How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide after combustion? See here first we have to write the chemical equation, that is important. See, how many moles of methane? Here also the hydrocarbon is methane. How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide after combustion? That means combustion of methane. Now write the equation. Methane CH4, it is in gaseous state. Combustion means reaction with oxygen, it is also in gaseous state. Now when hydrocarbons burn in presence of oxygen, then what are the products? Carbon dioxide and water. Now check whether the reaction is balanced or not. It is not balanced. Now balance it. To balance, you put 2. Here you put 2. Here you put 2. Okay, now write. Its coefficient is 1. That means 1 mole. Here 2 moles. Here 1 mole. Here 2 moles. What does it mean? What is the meaning of this? That means 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 mole of oxygen to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 mole of water. Then to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide, how many moles of methane is required? 1 mole. Okay, then to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide, how many moles of oxygen is required? 2 moles. Okay, now let us see question. How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide? See here, there are grams, so you write in grams. 1 mole of methane is equal to how many grams? Same 16 grams, 64, 44, because the equations are same. See here 16 grams, here 64 grams, here 44 grams, here 36 grams. Means that means 1 mole methane is equal to 16 grams, 2 mole oxygen is equal to 64 grams, 1 mole carbon dioxide is equal to 44 grams, 2 mole water is equal to 36 gram. See here, 16 gram of methane reacts with 64 gram of oxygen to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide and 36 gram of water. Now tell me, to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of methane is required according to balanced equation? How many grams of methane is required? 64 gram of methane is required to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide. Now here you write 16 gram of methane. 16 gram of methane produces how many grams of carbon dioxide? 44 gram of carbon dioxide. Okay, then what is in the question? How many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide? See here, to produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide, 16 gram of methane is required. Then to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of methane is required? Actually he is asking in moles. First you have to find out in grams, next you convert into moles. First you calculate in grams. See here, according to this balanced equation, 16 gram of methane gives 44 gram of carbon dioxide. Then to give 22 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of methane is required? This is the question. So here you cross multiple 16 gram into 22 divide by 44. Now you multiply this one. After multiplication you will get 8 grams, right? You'll get 8 grams. To produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of methane is required? 8 grams of methane is required. Then, but he is asking in moles. So you have to convert the grams into moles. What is the formula to calculate number of moles? Use number of moles n is equal to the mass of sample divide by molar mass. This is the number of moles is equal to mass of sample divide by molar mass. Now substitute the values. What is the mass of sample? 8 grams divide by, what is the molar mass? What is the molar mass of methane? 16. Now you divide these two values. Number of moles is equal to mass of sample divide by molar mass. What is the mass of sample? 8 grams. What is the molar mass of methane? 16 gram. Now divide these two. You will get 0.5 moles. See here. To produce 44 gram of carbon dioxide, 16 gram of methane is required. To produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide, 8 gram is required. That means 0.5 moles methane gives 22 gram of carbon dioxide. The next one, ammonia gas and hydrogen chloride gas combine to make ammonium chloride. What volume of ammonia at STP needed to react with 47.7 liter of hydrogen chloride at STP condition? STP means what? Standard temperature and pressure. Now let us see, First, you have to write the reaction. You have to write chemical reaction. Here, which is reactant and which is product? Here, ammonium gas and hydrogen chloride gas. They are combining. That means these two are reactants. To make ammonium chloride means to produce ammonium chloride. That's why it is product. Now let us write equation. Ammonium gas. That means ammonium gas. What is the formula? NH3. Right? Gas means G. Ammonium gas NH3 plus hydrogen chloride gas. That means what? HCl. HCl. Hydrogen chloride. These two combines and produce ammonium chloride NH4Cl. It is also gaseous state. It gives ammonium chloride. Ammonia reacts with hydrogen chloride and it gives ammonium chloride. Now let us write stoichiometric coefficients. What is stoichiometric coefficients? 1. Here 1. The stoichiometric coefficients are numerically equal to number of moles. That means 1 mole ammonia, 1 mole HCl, that here 1 mole ammonium chloride. When 1 mole of ammonia react with 1 mole of HCl, gives how many moles of ammonium chloride? 1 mole of ammonium chloride. Now let us see. Here they have given in liter, so you convert moles into liter. 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 22.4 liters. Here 1 mole is equal to how many liters? 22.4 liter. Here how many moles? 22.4 liters. Right? See here, 22.4 liter ammonia reacts with 22.4 liter HCl gas to produce 22.4 liter ammonium chloride. Okay, now by using this data, we have to calculate what volume of ammonia at STP needed to react with 47.7 liter of hydrogen chloride. Okay, see here, in according to this balanced equation, for 22.4 liter HCl, how many liters of ammonia is required? 22.4 liter. See here, for HCl, for 22.4 liter of HCl required, how many liters of ammonia? 22.4 liter. 22.4 liter. Then 22.4 liter of ammonia is required. Then for 47.7 liter of hydrogen chloride, 47.7 liter of hydrogen chloride required, how many liter of ammonia? That is the question. This is the question. Now you cross multiple this one, you will get answer. 47.7 liter into 22.4 liter divide by this one, 22.4 liter cancel. 22.4 get cancel. The next remaining is 47.7 liter of ammonia is required. For 47.7 liter of hydrogen chloride, 47.7 liter of ammonia is required. Okay, this is the answer. Next, go for fourth one. How many moles of propane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide after combustion? See, first you have to write the equation. Here, what is the reactant? Propane. Combustion of propane. That means what? Burning of propane in presence of oxygen. Propane. What is the chemical formula of propane? C3H8. This is a propane. Combustion means burning in presence of oxygen, O2. It is also gas. Now when hydrocarbon, this is also hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means what? The compound contains hydrogen and carbon. Yes, here there are carbon and hydrogen, that's why it is hydrocarbon. When hydrocarbon is burned in presence of excess oxygen, then what are the products? Same, carbon dioxide and water. The products are same, carbon dioxide and water gas. Now check whether the reaction is balanced or not. The equation is not balanced. Why? Because here there are three carbons, here one carbon, so we have to balance it. Now in reactant side there are three carbon, in product side there is only one carbon, so to balance carbon just you put it three. Next we have to balance hydrogen. Here how many hydrogens are there? 8 hydrogens are there. In product side how many hydrogens are there? 2 hydrogens. Now to balance hydrogen we have to put 4. We have to put 4. Next balance oxygen. In reactant side how many oxygens are there? 2. In product side 3 to 6. 6 plus 4. Total how many oxygens are there? 10. Here how many oxygens are there? 2. That's why you put 5. Now the equation is balanced. Now you write stoichiometric coefficients. What is the stoichiometric coefficient of propane? 1. Here 5. Here 3. Here 4. These are the stoichiometric coefficients. The stoichiometric coefficients are numerically equal to number of moles. Then its coefficient is 1, that means 1 mole, 1 mole of propane. Its stoichiometric coefficient is 5, that means 5 mole of oxygen. Here the coefficient is 3, that means 3 mole of carbon dioxide. Here what is the coefficient? 4, that means 4 mole of water. Now let us compare the number of moles of reactants and products. See here, 1 mole of propane react with 5 mole of oxygen to produce 3 mole of carbon dioxide and 4 mole of water, right? Now tell me, for 1 mole of propane to produce 3 mole of carbon dioxide, how many moles of oxygen is required? 5 moles of oxygen is required according to balanced chemical equation. Okay, to produce 4 mole of water, how many moles of propane is required? 1 mole of propane is required. Now let us check in the question. Here also they have given in grams, so you write in grams. 1 mole of propane is equal to how many grams? Just you calculate. 1 mole of propane is equal to molar mass of propane. Now calculate the molar mass of propane. What is the molar mass of propane? 44 grams. 1 mole of propane is equal to 44 gram. Similarly, 5 mole of oxygen is equal to how many grams? 160 grams. Similarly, 3 mole of carbon dioxide is equal to how many grams? 132 grams. Then 4 moles of water is equal to how many grams? 72 grams. See here, 44 gram of propane reacts with 160 gram of oxygen to produce 132 gram of carbon dioxide and 72 gram of water. See here, to produce 132 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of propane is required? 44 gram of propane is required. Now compare these two. 44 gram of propane, 44 gram of propane gives how many grams of carbon dioxide? 132 grams of carbon dioxide. 132 grams of carbon dioxide. Okay, next in the question, how many moles of propane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide? First you calculate in grams, later you convert them into moles. First, to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide, 22 gram of carbon dioxide, how many grams of propane is required? Now cross multiple. 44 gram into 22 gram divide by 132 gram. Multiply this one. How much you will get? 7.33 grams. We'll get 7.33 grams. How many grams of propane is required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide? We required 7.33 gram. But he is asking in moles. So we have to convert the mass of substance in moles. What is the formula? The number of moles. N is equal to mass of sample. Mass of sample means 7.33 grams divided by molar mass. Molar mass of propane. What is the molar mass? 44 gram. Right? Now you divide these two values. After dividing, you will get 0.166 moles. This is the answer. How many moles of propane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide? We required 0.166 moles of propane.